All right, surprise, surprise. This one is not a Mustang. I was looking for a Jeep and came across a project a fella had been working on for 10 years and had changed his mind and decided it was time to get rid of it. So I bought it. It was all new parts. It hadn't been driven. It wasn't street legal. He was building it to be a rock crawler for off-road only. Of course, once I bought it, I took it back to my shop, took it apart, and proceeded to make it a very nice show quality build. There was a lot involved in getting this Jeep to the quality I wanted and also street legal. It was never a Jeep, so it had no VIN. Everything was bought new and was custom. So once I finished the Jeep, I had to go through the process of getting all the various inspections and getting a VIN for the car to be street legal. Because it was made for off-road only, it didn't have provisions for doors, seat belts, a neutral safety switch or a clutch safety switch, reverse lights. There was a lot. So you'll see throughout this video how I made those things. And because I didn't want to deal with any rust, everything was powder coated, stainless steel, or aluminum. time to mate the Rock Crew Jeep CJ8 with the body. So we got a Mac in the level 3 frame. Got a Black Diamond XCL suspension, Atlas 2. Klune 4-1, 5-speed transmission, 350, 385 horsepower fast burn creek motor, big worn winch, and then the aluminum tub. So once we get the body on, we'll be able to hook everything up. Made it where basically everything with the chassis can stay with the chassis and everything with the body stays with the body, except for just 3 quick disconnect electrical connectors, so easy to take the body on and off with very little to do. Alright. Disc front and rear. TK1 sway bar, a little custom with the brackets and the links and how it attaches. All new custom brake lines. Got the stainless steel braided going up the control arms up to a hard line. That's it, Todd, by the way. And then you've got the hard lines going along the body, protected, or the frame, that is. And then I'll be cutting and mating to the body there. almost done with the custom CJ8 monster truck, rock crawler, whatever you want to call it. Everything on this is custom and new, nothing from an actual Jeep. It's a Mackens level 3 frame, some 9-inch axles. Beadlocks, aluminum tub, TK1, sway bar, that's the parking brake assembly, that's the tank with the pressure regulator going to the rear locker, and that's the main pressure over there. Frame, all the suspension components, make some diamond plate to go in there, just have to polish the tailgate. All the bolts, for the most part, are stainless, so no, even the shackles are stainless. So, with aluminum and steel, you could get some electrolysis, so we'll get that. That's a black smoke powder coat on the rear axle. It's got disc front and rear with integrated drum parking brake. There's the regulator. There's a hose going to the front and back for an air hose attachment. There's the rear air hose attachment. And then the front air hose attachment is over here. You need to tighten up the body bolts and stuff, but again, all stainless. You can see all these bolts, everything's stainless. Stainless, not cheap. Worn high-speed winch. The front also is powder coated in the black smoke. The hood, while new, it got a couple of dents and dings, so I'm going to get a new hood, and it will be painted silver, probably a black checkerboard, kind of like a World War II P-51 Mustang or a Corsair. Custom door panels. Made those out of diamond plate, as you can see, aluminum. So that center console, that one gauge is going to go back to a Phantom. I just, for some reason, it didn't work, the pressure gauge for the tank, so I'm getting a new one of those. That silver bezel is just in there temporarily. It's got a Klune 4-to-1, custom billet knobs. It's also got an Atlas 2. And a 5-speed, I believe it's an MB3550. Again, all bolts, all these bolts everywhere, stainless. Some nice aluminum Jeep pedals, parking brake, 5-point Mastercraft harnesses, as well as retractable seat belts in the front, and then just Mastercraft 5-point harnesses in the rear seat. Gotta take the tag off the seat. I'm going to get matching fronts for it, just haven't gotten around to it. These bars are removable, so if you're not off-roading, you know, you don't have to worry about hitting your head, you can just take those off. You know, need the extra protection. Let's see, so it's got a Chevy crate motor. as you saw from the tank inside, it has a compressor in place of where AC would be. This doesn't have a top, so you don't need AC. Let's see what else. Oh, I wired the winch up. The winch is here. The compressor, voltage, USB plug, cigarette lighter, got a sound bar up on top. It's the new Thor phonics. Some tunes up there. Gauges got fuel and volt. Speedo, RPM, oil pressure, oil temp, water temp. That fuel pressure I don't have hooked up. I'll probably put something else there. I don't really need fuel pressure. Vacuum, and then that bottom one is going to be the tank pressure. I have a 120 on, 150 off switch. Spacers, stainless bolts. Should be pretty fun. Fun little ride. All new. Bend all those brake lines and put stainless fasteners. A little more to do, it'll be done. Just got this new trailer and I was just test fitting it on the trailer, seeing where it balanced.